The letter completely tend to the sound.
I mean, there's not such a letter in Arabic, three dots below. It has to be up.
Exactly, that's right. So here's it. In bad, we just put one dot here, as we said before, but in tell, we put just two dots. And probably, anyone of you probably might ask, do we have a specific size for the dots? I mean, should we make the dots as a big one or as a small one? It depends.
Because I've seen people, you know, big dots, and sometimes get confused. It looks like three or two and a half.
Right.
It doesn't look too. They try and make like kites, small kites and dots.
Exactly. I think that's true.
Sometimes
right.
You can see it
without any dots.
Just a line.
That's a line,
just
right?
Just a line. Yeah.
Lots of times, yes, you can find that. By the way, and also for the fat, you can find something like that. In this way, probably we have here different types of calligraphy.
I've also seen someone like drawing M. Yep. See, because three dots like M, something like similar to M.
Yep.
Yeah,
it's
really
good, right? You think
exactly.
That was this M or a small M on the top or something.
Right, right. Something like that. Yeah. And what makes me sometimes confused is that I found a lot of Arabic language speakers probably when they write the alphabet, sometimes they don't use dots. Sometimes they forget to do something like that, and that probably can confuse you.
But by the way, I have something to say here. The Quran, in the past, before it was compiled in one book,
right.
It was without dots.
Right, right, I think that's right.
When they came to compile it during the time of Abu Bakr or Uthman,
right.
They put the dots when people, Muslims, differed around the pronunciation of some words, like Sabgha or Sana'a.
Sana'a, right.
Yes.
Right, that's true. Absolutely. Yeah, yes.
And the confusion.
Right.
Yeah.
And that's why I would say that dots today are very important in order to distinguish different letters inside the phonetic system of Arabic.
Yeah. And I think, Ahmed, also in English we have also dots, but I think there are only two dots we have in J and we have in I.
Oh, I think
and
that's
this is also especially in the lower case. But not in the upper case.
Exactly. I think that's absolutely correct, Osama.
Yeah.
I think that this is very important, actually, to talk more about the dots. And I still remember, I don't know who was the first one who probably proposed the idea of making dots in Arabic. Is that Abu Aswad al-Duali or someone like him? I don't know. I don't remember, actually, by the way. But again, I think that that's very important, actually, to know and to learn more about the dots. And I think we can discover more about the Arabic letters in the following episodes. Ladies and gentlemen, my dear viewers, I think that when it comes in Arabic language, we have a lot to explain and we have a lot to discover. And I think that is one of the powerful secrets of learning Arabic language, is just to learn how can we write the alphabets and the letters in the right and in the correct form. This is Ahmad Abdel Tawwab Sharafuddin. Thank you for joining us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Eyes for Allah, nothing but Allah. Ba is the beginning of Bismillah. Ta is for Taqwa, bewaring of Allah. And Tha is for Thawab, a reward.